Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm speaking about OLAMA, the framework OLAMA, how to install it and use it. Very simple framework to test and prototype and work with different LLMs. Let's go and I will show you this in a second. Okay. I create as well a notebook with all the documentation and links that you probably want to take a look in details later after watching the video. But well, essentially you have here the main repository with all the information that you need to install. I install it in Windows System Linux in two versions I had, Ubuntu 22.04 and Debian 8, if I'm not wrong. You can try to install it as well in a Linux variant. It's also it's not working in Windows so far, but well, from in my case I don't care. It's I'm always using Linux variants for the stuff I'm doing, and also you can install it in MacOS. Well, I recommend you to use this automatic installation. It's just downloading the script, the install script and execute it. You install the framework, the OLAMA framework, ready to go. If you already had the, like in my case, the System Linux configured to use the GPU of your machine, I'm working currently on my computer with a NVIDIA 1650 with 4 GB. You will see that it's working. It's not the best performance, but it's working in a small GPU with 4 GB, and we are running models like Llama 2 or Mistral, even Mistral 13 billion, sorry, Llama 2 13 billions are working in my machine. I recommend you in any case to do this setup, which is really easy. Just execute the script, that's all. It's not if you have some specific requirement or you prefer to follow and control completely the all the steps of the installation, because you don't trust too much in what they are doing. You can follow the manual strat and set up the service and start and stop the service manually. Everything that you can do it step by step is very well documented. This is for a Ubuntu Debian variant, but well, you can adapt this script easily to your favorite Linux flavor. Once you have this installed, if you are working in a Windows System Linux or Linux, you will have to start the server. So OLAMA, how it works is a framework with essentially is an application server which offers you some entry points which you can use for different purposes, but you can manage the whole application using the endpoints, the entry points, and also you can use command line, and you can install new models, text which models you have installed on the framework, do inference. Obviously, you can do inference. You cannot train a model, at least for what I see to now. Still, no, you cannot train a new model. You can install a model that you train offline and install it on the framework, or fine tune a model, whatever you fine tune. You can install it later and use it on the framework. You can do inference. There is three main endpoints. That is embeddings, generate, and chat. We will discuss all of them later, and I will show you how it works. If you are working, we will look at the Docker installation in some seconds. But if you are working in a Linux or Windows System Linux, you just simply, once you finish the installation, you just execute OLAMA serve, and OLAMA serve will run the application server and start to serve start to listen for requests in the port 11434, and everything is working. Is the application is working, listening on that port, and you had mapped different entry points for different purposes. Here, you execute OLAMA, you will see all the commands that you had available, service to start the application, create a model for a model file. Show is just to show the information that how to manage a model, how to interact with a model that you install, run a model. If you run a model and you don't have it, automatically do a pull. Here you had a push to the registry. You had you create a model for a model registry. You can push this model as well to the registry in Hugging Face. You can list the model. You can copy a model from one of the systems to with another name. You can remove a model from the repository available in OLAMA. So you see here I execute, this is in my Ubuntu installation. I execute here OLAMALIST, and then on OLAMALIST essentially is doing a request, a GET to the application server, and it's asking for the tags, and we get this. This is the models I already installed here. I already have installed here on my Windows or System Linux, and I cannot test this now because I had the Docker running, and they are serving in the same port. And as I want to show you how to do the Docker, how to set up the Docker, and we will work with the Docker instead to work with my setup on the Linux, on the Ubuntu Linux, on the Debian Linux. This is I had this application server down, no? But you can see that this the same list you will see it now or similar, because in the other, in the Docker, I don't have installed the Orca Mini. I only had the Llama 2 or Mistral and Mistral. Orca I didn't install so far. Let's move to the instructions, how you install new models. You do it for command line. Later on, we will see how to interact with the API through the Python library. By the way, you have two libraries, one in Python, the other one in JavaScript, so you can choose your favorite language. I install obviously the Python version. Now we will talk about the Docker, and once you had the application running, you just run OLAMA run model name, and if you don't have it installed, it will automatically pull the model from Hugging Face and start to run. And once the model is pulled, it will start it automatically. You can use it immediately for inference. So you can have multiple models running at the same time, so it's very easy to. But obviously, there is one time that you need to download it to local, and then only it can be used inside the framework. Okay. Here you had a list of the available models you had to work integrated on the framework. There is approximately 40. There is different versions of Mistral, of Llama, Orca Mini, Vicuna. Well, there is another version of the Llama 2. Well, a lot is well. Again, it allows you to do a lot of experimentation, a lot of the prototyping very quickly. It's working very well. And again, I'm working in a machine in my desktop. It's not very powerful. Probably you can get better outcomes if you work in a server in the cloud, but you can also run it in a conventional desktop like the one I have, and well, it's going to be a little bit slow, especially when you use the generate interface to work with prompts or the chat one, especially the generate one. is working a little bit slow, even using the GPU I have on my machine. No, but okay, it's fine for the purpose of the video. Is more than enough. No, let's move now to the Docker. The Docker is also pretty easy to install. They had already image on Docker Hub, and well, it's done simple than run the image. If you don't have it, obviously it will be pulled to your Docker environment, to your machine, like in my case. And if you run it this way, you will run it without GPU support. If you don't have your Docker configured to Docker, yeah, your Docker installation is not configured with the GPU support, you will need to follow these steps to download the NVIDIA Container Toolkit and install it in your host server, in the Docker host. And once you have it, you can run the container, the Ollama container with GPU support. Don't forget that this is the way that you can map the available GPUs to your Docker container. And as I mentioned before, everything is running behind the port 11434. Pretty easy. Well, in two clicks you had the Docker running. In my case, as I had everything set up to work with a GPU, in my Docker installation, Kubernetes as well, and also the Windows System Linux, it was a piece of cake to do this. Just follow the instructions and ready to go. Once you had the Docker install, automatically start the Docker and it execute the Docker the command server Ollama serp, and then automatically start the server and start to listen for any petitions that you may do. So you can go here, we are in the logs section. You can go to the exit version. Here I just execute bash just to have a prompt, a bash prompt. In my case, as I said, I had a NVIDIA support installed in the Docker. So as you see here, I had CUDA 12.1, NVIDIA GTX 1650 with 4 GB, and this is working here without any problem. As you see here, the process Ollama is running on the GPU, and then is using practically half of the GPU is taken by the Ollama application server. If you do here Ollama list, you will see that I already had two models installed. The same, I have three on the Windows System Linux, and here only two. I didn't install yet the Orca Mini or other. But the process to install it is exactly the same for any. You just make here either Ollama pull model name or Ollama run model name. If you do Ollama run, if you don't have it installed, automatically it will download the model from Hugging Face registry, and it will run the model and ready to do inference. Okay, let's check now. The Python library. The Python library, you had as well a repository. I put the link on the Jupyter notebook. Simply pip install Ollama, ready to go. I suppose that the JavaScript is working similarly. I didn't test it. I usually work with Python, so well, those that are more familiar with JavaScript, they can try and do it themselves. No? The Python library is also working with either command line like Python or JavaScript. All of them, there is also a link here to the API, to the documentation. You can also work with a simple curl calling to the entry points. There is different entry points, the chat API, here, for example, we are. This is the chat as well. Sorry, chat as well. Chat. Create a model. You can create a model as well via POST. It's just simply sending requests to the application server to the different entry points. They have the different ones. All of them are described here. You have the list models, get IP tags. This is exactly the same that at the end of the day, when you are executing the command line, is simply sending a get or sending a post, depending on the command that you are running on the command line, and exactly the same what the Python is doing. Python is you just install, import the Python or llama list. And now if you look at the logs, we just get AP tags. Okay. And if you see here, when I do a request from Python, it's taking the private address of the Docker, and when you are doing using the command line, it's taking the loopback address, IP address. So you can differentiate those just looking at the IP address that are logging in the system logs. Okay, so we have two models installed. I execute when you execute pull, you just simply pull the model from the repository. We can run it again. If you have it installed, it will just make a test, and well, it takes some seconds to check that you have the model, you have the latest version. It make a query as well to Hugging Face, just to check that you have the latest model installed on your machine. You see here I did before a test, some minutes before, and well, it took 15. No, this is the pull, sorry. A pull from a model. Let's check how long it takes. Okay, here we are. No, no, sorry, still not. Let me check. One second. Still testing, but it should come the prompt. Yeah, exactly. We have a status success as we had already the model installed. It's make a pull. And we are just posting to the pull entry point API slash pull, and it took 51 seconds. Again, my machine is not the most powerful in the world, so even having a i7, Intel i7 with 64 GB of memory, but well, yeah, these large models and the operation is working slowly, so it's not a production environment what I'm showing you. Okay, so another interface entry point is embeddings. You can do as well this using the command interface. And then here, if you saw the videos I posted before when we were working with the LangChain library and integrating this with your Llama framework and working to produce embeddings using Llama 2 as well as Mistral and Orca Mini, we just simply send the model. It's an around. This is here, exactly. This is the video I posted a couple of days ago. And then, as you can see here, this is the class that grabbed the Llama framework in LangChain, and that's very simple. You just say the model you want to use, the GPU, show progress. You send the documents. This is the LangChain's documents. You say the embeddings. I'm using here Llama to generate embeddings with this model, and then on I work using here Chroma with cosine similarity and persisting the embeddings that I create with the Llama 2 in the Chroma database. I persisting to this, But just again, to the same that we did on LangChain, we can do it directly with the Python library. This is outside the LangChain space, and you just simply do the same. You can set here the model, the prompt. The prompt is the, how to say, the text that you want to get the embeddings, and some options that you have described on the documentation, and to keep alive, just to do a pin, because sometimes it take a while. This, let's do a try. It's taking some seconds as well. Now it's activating the GPU. It's moving the processing to the GPU, and well, it took nine, almost 10 seconds to produce the embeddings. We look the response. It's just a JSON with a key, embeddings, and the key is, as you can imagine, 4096, 96 length, the length of the embeddings. You can use as well to generate tests. Here I'm using the model to generate to send it a prompt, generate some Python code. It's gonna take 5 6 minutes. I will stop the recording here, and once it's done, I will show you the logs and the response of the model that what you can see here, but maybe now it's sending something different. See you soon. Okay, here we are, finished. It took 5 minutes, which, well, this for a production environment is not acceptable, but well, for this environment, where I'm doing some prototypes, is enough. But yeah, let's review what we get. We get here some additional keys when you use the generate. Also, obviously, when you are generating text, interacting the LLM, you have different attributes. You can set temperature, all the usual parameters that you can use when you work with the LLMs. We got all these keys as a response. I make a printout of what we get. You see here even the tokens that the context that we send to the LLM, the duration, etc., etc. Probably bank count. Okay. So not bad. A lot of the stuff there. Here is the response that the model return back. Here, well, it sends some two, three, four different versions of how you can open a PDF in Python. So not bad. It's PyPDF, pandas, PDF documents, and PyPDF 3. I didn't test the code. Well, you can do it, or you can send another prompt and just test if this is working properly. In other tests I made, the code they usually produces is good, is working. It's not the best quality, but it's working. Yeah, so as initial point, many times is a good tool just to interrogate a model and give you a tip or some tips to start the process if you don't master one of the languages. I use this in some of the stuff I was doing the recent months to work out how to to do some stuff in JavaScript because a library I need to integrate for Neo4j visualization, and then well I just another tool I have here installed in I wanted to tell you something about that, about ImageNQ, but well for another video. Today we are focusing in Olama. Okay, now Olama list this we look at this before, and well now we can take a look to Olama chat. You will see one of the things that I showed you in previous videos about the prompt engineering. Yeah, is now we are doing a streaming of the answer. He obviously Llama 2 is answering something which is probably was correct 2 years ago. Today well after Boris Johnson there was 2 prime ministers, the I don't remember the name of the lady who was practically 1 month no more in power, and then on Sunil Runak, that is the current prime minister. But yeah, this is because the model was trained with information yeah, that is currently outdated, and then we may use RAG or some retrievers in LangChain to get information that is outdated to leverage the answer of the chat. But this is not the purpose of the video, it's just to show you how to install and use Olama. Pretty simple, in my opinion. You can do a lot of tests with the different. By the way, if you want to install now a model, we will just start it right now. We can use to install, we can try one of these ones. So, let me try, I don't know. I didn't install Falcon, for example. Yeah, Olama from Falcon. Yeah, it's just you have different versions. Olama from Falcon 7b. Let's test this one. And then you just right here. Pull and let's take a look to the logs. Yeah, it started to download. If you check here, yeah, it started to download already. I don't have it installed. This is gonna take a while, probably 1 hour, 15 minutes, depending on the size of the model. Yeah, the previous one it took 52 minutes, one, and the other one 1 hour. You can check, as I said before, the size here with Olama list. Yeah, depending on the size, it will take round about 1 hour in this size. We are downloading 7 billion model. Yeah, probably similar size to what we had in Mistral on Llama 2, so approximately 1 hour. And well, that's all. I hope you like the content of the video. I find it really interesting. By the way, we can use practically all these models come in the format GGUF exactly. This is a new format developed recently by this guy. I put you some links here. You can read some information about this model. It's the model that is working on Llama CPP, that is, you know, is a version of Llama that is essentially developed on C++, C++, and with some bindings in Python, and it was designed to quickly load models and also to optimize models. Obviously, if it is using C++, is going to be faster. No, later on, the how it's going to work with the Python bindings is another story. But well, in general, we can say that it's going to be fast, or faster than running in Python. All Also, this guy developed this new format, GGUF, and you can take a look here in this link. I found it as well before recording this video. What are the differences with the conventional tensors used before that Python use, and what are the advantages to use this format? So this you can use in Olama both formats. You can decide. You can import for GGUF, or you can install SafeTensors or PyTorch. It's up to you. So by default, it's time not grown. I can confirm you that it's gonna be the GGUF version of the model. And again, I hope you like the video. If you like it, give me a like. And you see here, still connecting, still downloading. Again, it's gonna take a while. It's downloading chunks. And again, if you like the video, give me a like. And if you are not subscribed, it's now time to do it. And also something I repeat the last videos. If you want to me to make a video about a topic, about a specific setup that you want to discuss about some integration, let me know in the chat, and I will prepare it, and I will show to the rest how to do whatever. No, if not, I will be publishing other videos about other topics I'm working on. And now, see you soon. Thank you very much for watching me. Thank you. Bye.